Hey everybody, how are you? It's Mary, and I'm super excited about this particular installment of our nutrition lessons. I'm going to talk to you today about meal planning and a little bit about prep. It's one of our favorite topics, and so this is the beginner session. So, I'm not sure what you do as far as planning your meals every week or your lunches or snacks, but here's what goes on in our house. There's four of us. My husband and I, and then our two children, Matthew and Audrey, who are both, of course, in school. Matthew's in high school and Audrey's in the junior high. So one of the first things that I do on a usual weekend is that I will pull out our calendar. So I have our family calendar and then I have my personal calendar. And I take a look at what we have going on for the week. Any volleyball practices, swim practice, which of course happens all the time. It feels like all the time. School meetings, church meetings, any of that kind of stuff. And I just lay that out on the calendar. And I have this amazing little tool that I use to plan our meals as well as make our grocery list side by side. So sometimes what I do is I just draw out a little grid. Like here's the meals that we have and here's Monday through Friday. So I kind of get a visual of what we need and what we have on hand. So breakfasts are always covered because we have shakes every day for breakfast. And then I think about snacks. What are the kinds of things that we would like to have as snacks? Granola and yogurt, maybe some cheese sticks, peanut butter with fruits and veggies, all of that sort of thing. So I just kind of pencil some things in, thinking about planning lunches for people who have to take a lunch with them. Maybe I'll find out what days people don't need lunches, if there's a special schedule or Dave has a special meeting, all that kind of thing. So I just do the roadmap. This is really important in this dinner area because sometimes what goofs us up is we realize we planned a meal and then we actually don't have time to make that meal because we have a sports practice or a meeting after school or a parent-teacher conference or a doctor's appointment or whatever it is that runs over and voila, we run out of time. Even when you work from home, you run out of time to make dinner. So we do maybe 15 minutes or so of just planning. And then thinking about what is it that we want to eat, right? So then I go to my go-tos. I've got some, I love to buy these things. I just bought this one, I think in December, Better Homes and Gardens special production publications that, you know, some new recipes and things like that. So, and then I have my cookbook, which is my go-to weeknight cookbook. So maybe you have cookbooks that you like or special recipes that are the best for your family, most tasty, what have you. But I pull out some things and I begin crafting what it is that I intend on serving for dinner. Who's gonna be there? What I plan leftover nights. I plan digging my freezer nights and see what's there, all of that kind of thing. And I begin to put things down on paper. So that is where it all begins. All right, so then what? Then what seems to be the biggest challenge for us is making sure that people have food for lunches and snacks during the day. Dinners I can pretty much make happen. So we do not have matching containers or all of that sort of thing. We have Ziploc bags. We use a lot of Ziploc bags, snack size, sandwich size, which we're out of right now, quart size. And then I do use these little containers, these little Ziploc disposable containers. This is perfect for powder, for shake mixes and stuff like that, or it's just perfect for maybe a little macaroni salad or coleslaw or something like that inside lunches. I like to use these because Audrey's an olive eater, so I'll throw olives inside here so she can take olives for her lunch, as, you know, other stuff too. We use this for yogurt, and then we might put the granola or fruit, cut up fruit in here so that we've got the yogurt granola thing going on. And here's some of the snacks that we have on hand. Hard-boiled eggs, of course, yogurt with our beverage snack mix, cheese sticks, and all of those things that we learned about the other day in our snacking component. But what I really want to show you is how we stage our food the night before for the next day. Because if you want to have a really great day, you got to start the night before. This is literally what happens. Let me clear my space. We line up the people who are taking a lunch. So Dave gets a post-it, Matthew gets a post-it, Audrey gets a post-it. Napkins for everybody. And then if they don't like their fruit chilled, we'll leave the fruit out the night before. So a couple of clementines, a bag of mixed nuts. Here we've got the apple all cleaned and ready to go for Matthew. And we have the apple cutter. So in the morning, Matthew will cut his apple. He'll throw it. I'll even put the Ziploc bag here. He'll cut the apple, put it in the Ziploc bag, and go. We pre-packaged the little pretzel snacks, and according to the serving size is 15 pretzel squares, and so 15 go in his bag. Same for Audrey, she's got two little clementines there. So that's the stuff that can sit out on the counter overnight. Audrey's lunch bag, Matthew's lunch bag. In the fridge are the sandwiches, the wraps, the soup that we might warm up. Say Audrey's gonna take soup, she likes to do a little thermos situation. We'll set the clean thermos right here, and then we'll warm up the soup in the morning. So we're ready to go as much as we can so that when it's time to do things in the morning, everybody knows what they need to do to complete their lunch. We aren't scrambling or starting in the morning. That's what makes for a really awesome day. And then we just do it all over again every night. Weekends, like this weekend, we have two recipes. I'm gonna post them for granola bars. So we'll be making some granola bars and snack bars because we love those and those are great for lunches. And what else will we do? We've got the hard-boiled eggs. I'll probably clean a bunch of celery and carrot sticks so that we have that cut up and ready to go for lunches or for dinners, you know, if we want some fresh veggies with our dinners. So that is, I hope that gives you some ideas. That is the starting point for meal planning and prep. It's the thinking portion and then some daily habits that help us just be on it. We didn't always do this. We used to make our lunches in the morning and it drove me crazy because that was when we were reaching for prepackaged processed foods to make it easy for ourselves. If we just take 10 minutes the night before and we all help, we are so much more ready, more prepared, and more healthy than we would be otherwise. All right, so there will be more details about what exactly you can put into your meal prep over and above the snacking thing that we talked about the other day, but this is a good start for you. And since it's the weekend, you can kind of think about, all right, I'm gonna go grocery shopping. How do I wanna get ready for my week? What are the things I wanna eat? And map it out on a piece of paper. All right, if you found that helpful, let us know in the comments below and let us know what you might change in your meal plan and prep for the week. All right, everybody. Bye now.